Believe it or not, this is a computer, and I can control my entire home theater with just this. Let's discuss. So, what is this? So, as I mentioned before, this is a computer, but this is actually a Raspberry Pi. Now, if you don't know what Raspberry Pi is, if you've never heard of it, or if you're like, what is this dude talking about? Then, you know, go on Google, you can Google Raspberry Pi and find out, you know, the history behind it, why it's called a Raspberry Pi. Very interesting. But this is a computer and it's small, but it's very, very powerful. So this company reached out to me and asked me if I would be interested in, you know, reviewing this on my channel. And anybody that follows the channel knows that this channel is a home theater channel first, but I also love pretty much all things tech. And I'm very big into home automation, into security, and all that stuff with HomeKit. So this thing, as I said, is very powerful. You can do a ton of stuff with this. You can code with this thing. It's very amazing what all the things that you can do. Now, I won't go into the detail on all the things that this can do. Like I said, you can go and look it up. But some of the things that you can do with this is you can make an emulator. So I know some people who have actually built an arcade, like a legit arcade that you would, you know, arcade machine, the retro arcade machines that have the joysticks and little, you know, pads and everything. You can put an emulator on here and put thousands upon thousands of games, retro games. But what I'm using this for is HomeBridge. So if you follow the channel, you know that I use HomeKit as my home automation for my home automation. And HomeBridge allows you to integrate products that don't have native HomeKit support. And HomeBridge allows you to download plugins, and then it's usually very simple. And you can basically put your smart lights, your smart accessories that aren't compatible with HomeKit natively, and you can use HomeBridge. And for the past couple years, I've been using HomeBridge on a Windows 10 machine, or Windows 11, a computer that I built myself for my PLEX server. So it's running my PLEX server, but I also put HomeBridge on there. HomeBridge can run on Windows, Mac, but originally HomeBridge was built on Raspberry Pi infrastructure. So I've been using HomeBridge on my, you know, Windows computer, and it's been pretty solid, but there are definitely times when it just does not want to do what I want it to do. Again, it's probably way more fewer times than the times when I don't have issues with it, but there's times when it just drives me nuts. And I think it's because of the Windows integration. It works and it served me well, but I think that because HomeBridge runs on this natively, like this is what it was built on, I think it's gonna be a lot more stable. And I've been using it for a week. I backed up all my stuff on, you know, my HomeBridge on my Windows 10 computer. And then I basically just uninstalled HomeBridge on my Windows computer, installed it on here. And actually, this is the only thing that it's running. You can actually download HomeBridge as a operating system. So when this thing boots up, it just boots up to HomeBridge, and that's all that I have on it. That's all that I'm using it for. I don't want to clutter this with anything else, but it's been running super stable so far. And actually, let me open this up and show you what this looks like. It's very simple. So if I take this off, this is the top. And then let me take my USB out. So this is the computer. You can see how tiny it is. And it's got a little fan on here, but basically it comes with a little case. It comes with a micro SD card. So take that out on the back. I can get it out. Yeah, so there's your micro SD card. It runs off of this. So basically what you do is you put this inside of a normal SD card reader, and then you can basically download whatever software that you want on here. Again, I'm just running HomeBridge, so slide that back in there. But yeah, there's your computer. So it's got four USB ports. It's got two USB type A, I believe. And then you have your USB 3.1, and then there's an Ethernet. And then on the side, you've got these micro USB, micro HDMI, I'm sorry. So over here, I don't know if you can see that, but it's got these micro USB, keep saying micro USB, micro HDMI to regular size HDMI. So you plug in your micro HDMI, and then you plug the other end into your monitor, and that's pretty much it. Like, it's super simple. Let me put this back on. But yeah, it's super easy. Literally, all you do is you just screw down the motherboard onto the case, the bottom of the case. You plug in the fan, you snap this on top, get your Ethernet going, and I believe this has Wi-Fi as well. But it's super easy. You don't have to do anything. It's not like building a computer. All the parts come, you just put them together. There's no soldering. You know, you don't have to use any thermal paste, anything like that. It comes with these little things that you, you know, the little thermal, it's not paste, but these heat sinks. And it comes with three heat sinks, and it's got some adhesive on the back. You just stick it on there. Super easy, but very, very powerful. So I'm running, as I said, I'm running HOMEBRIDGE on this. And HOMEBRIDGE is really cool because I have my Harmony remote and my Harmony hub. I have a plugin for that because there's no native support for HomeKit. I have my Govee lights, a light strip, no native support for that. I have some PLEX plugins and a ZIDOO plugin. So I can use all those things together and I can control my home theater. I use voice command to turn on most of the times. I still use my Harmony remote to turn on my, you know, my home theater. But I usually just say, you know, hey, Apple AI of choice. And I create a scene and it turns on it connects to my Harmony and it turns on all my components. And then I just grab my remote and, you know, turn it on. If I'm feeling lazy and I don't want to use a remote, or if I'm just walking into the room, or before I walk into the room, I can, you know, say a command to my hub, my Apple hub, and it turns everything on. Super, super, super awesome. And then I can use plugins to control my lights when I hit play, pause, or stop with PLEX or ZIDOO. And if you want to find out how to do that, I have some videos on my channel. I have a three-part tutorial on how to integrate PLEX with HomeKit via HOMEBRIDGE. And then I have a tutorial on how to integrate ZIDOO with HomeKit via HomeBridge. So really cool videos, check those out. I'll leave a link in the description and in the comments. But I just wanted to make a quick video to let you know that, you know, you can get this and it's super easy, super configurable. You can do all kinds of stuff. You can run a whole security system. You can even block ads on your entire network with this thing, which I've done before. But yeah, and I believe at the time of this video, you can get this for $200. So, you know, some people might say, ah, that's a little bit more expensive. But if you think about, you know, going and building a computer, you're gonna spend probably at least $1,000. And you don't have to really do anything. You just put the pieces together. There's videos on YouTube, if you know how to do it, that'll show you how to do it. So again, Raspberry Pi, this is the Raspberry Pi 4. Awesome, awesome piece of gear. I love this thing. I think this is gonna be much less headache than using HOMEBRIDGE on my Windows 10 computer, my Windows 11 computer. So that's it, guys. Quick video, just to let you know. I will leave a link in the description to purchase this on Amazon if you want to, and it will be an affiliate link. So if you wanna purchase this or you wanna purchase anything on Amazon, I would really appreciate it if you use those links. So thank you for watching, guys, and I will catch you in the next video.